Hi friends, I am Dr. Prabodh Halde. I am President-elect of AFST CFTRI Mysore. I will be continuing with the module 2 of the food categorization with respect to the FSSA regulation, which includes a description of the various food categories. As we have seen in the module 1 of the food categorization, why the Food Safety and Standard Authority of India has developed the food categorization. Basically, it has given a simplification to the food categories, how to identify the product under which categories. The basic objective of the food categories, what we have seen in earlier module 1, is to get the detail about a requirement of the food product in precise nomenclature form and detailed description of the various foods. The food category system is based on the product description of the foodstuff as marketed unless otherwise stated. The food category descriptors are not to be legal product designations and not intended for labeling purposes. It is just for the licensing and regulation. The food category system is used to simplify the product of the food additives used for assembling and constructing in this regulation. So basically, the food categorization is done for the regulation, for the licensing and registration. It is not a legal product designation for the labeling purposes. So these are the limitations. There are total 18 categories. Category number 1 to category number 16 describe the various food, which includes the fats and oil, dairy and fruits, vegetable and so on and so forth. Category number 17 are the category which are not covered in earlier categories, which 1 to 16. So this is kept for the innovation. And category number 99 is covering the substances which are added into the food as additives. So there are total 18 categories. Now we will see what are those 18 categories. In this module, we will be going into the detail about each category. And also we will see some examples in each category. So far, it must be clear to you that all the food items which we eat, and it covers all the state of India, which will get included in one of the categories. You name any product, it will get included in either number 1 or number 15 of the categories. Which are those 18 categories? Category number 1 is a dairy product and its analog. Category number 2 is fats and oil and fat emulsion. Category number 3 is edible ices including sorbet. Category number 4 is fruits and vegetable. Category number 5 is confectionery items. Category number 6 is cereal and cereal products. Category number 7 is bakery products. Category number 8 is meat and meat product. Category number 9 is fish and fish product. Category number 10 is egg and egg product. Category number 11 is sweeteners, which are added to the food for sweetening purposes. Category number 12 includes salt, spices, soups, sauces, salads and protein products. Category number 13 are the products of the food products which are for intended for particular nutrition, so food for medical purposes and dietary foods. Category number 14 covers all the beverages. Category number 15 covers ready to eat savories. Category number 16 are the prepared foods like idli, dosa, pizza and all those. Category number 17 are the others which are not included in 1 to 16. So there is a room for innovation. Category number 19, which is actually 18th category, is substances added to the food, maybe for preservation, maybe for the additive, flavoring or coloring. So friends, we will see now each category in detail. The category number 1, as we mentioned in earlier, is a dairy product and its analog. It covers all the dairy product including the plain and flavored and its analog. So you will see 1.1 category called milk and dairy based drinks, which includes milk and buttermilk, milk, buttermilk plain, dairy-based drinks like flavored and non-fermented or fermented drinks yogurt or whey-based drinks. Under the same category, 1.2, which includes fermented and rennetted milk products, which are plain, or dairy-based drinks. It also includes 1.2.1, fermented milk plain, or not heat-treated after fermentation. It also includes fermented milks heat-treated after fermentation. So it carries some kind of microbes, or in the other category, there are no microbes because it is heated after fermentation. Then 1.2.2, which includes rennetted milks. It also includes 1.3, condensed milk plain, beverage, whiteners, cream, and likewise product. So in nutshell, in the category number 1, dairy products and its analog, up to 1.4, it contains all the kind of milk beverages, including condensed milk and a cream analog. You can actually see the detailed presentation as in the slide. When we go on, the categorization also has described under the dairy, milk powder and cream powder. Milk powder and cream powder plain, milk and cream powder analog, unripened cheese, ripened, rind of ripened cheese powder and whey cheese. It also includes a processed cheese, plain processed cheese, flavored processed cheese, including containing fruits, vegetable and meats. Cheese analog, whey protein cheese, dairy-based desserts, whey and whey product excluding whey cheese, liquid whey and whey product excluding whey cheese, and dried whey and whey product excluding whey cheese. These are also a part of the dairy products and its analog. Now we'll come to the category number 2, which is fats and oil and fat emulsions. The fats and oil has a vast product range. It includes a fat-based products that are derived from vegetable, animal, marine sources and their mixtures. We will see in the fats and oil and fat emulsion products. The 2.1 describes fat and oil essentially free from water, like butter oil, anhydrous milk fat, ghee, vegetable oils and fats, lard, tallow, fish oil and other animal fats. It also includes 2.2 fat emulsions, mainly for water in oil emulsion. So which is like a butter or fat spread or dairy fat spread and blended spreads. It includes 2.3 a fat emulsion mainly for the type of oil in water, including mixtures and or flavored product based on fat emulsion. In 2.4, it is a fat-based desserts, excluding dairy-based desserts, product of food categories 1.7. Example, cocoa-based spreads, including fillings. We'll come to the category number 3, which is edible ices, including sherbet and sorbet. This category includes a water-based frozen desserts, confections, and novelties such as fruit, sorbet, Italian-style ice, flavored ice, frozen desserts containing primary dairy ingredients, which are included in food category 1.7. We will see the detailed description. You can also refer to our notes, which has given a detailed description. We'll come to the category number 4, which is fruits and vegetables, including mushrooms, fungi, roots, tubers, pulses, and legumes, and aloe vera. It also includes seaweeds and nuts and seeds. In this category, category number 4, there are major two categories, fruits and vegetables. 4.1 is a fruits, 4.2 is a vegetable, including mushrooms, fungi, roots, tubers, pulses, and legumes, and aloe vera. Each of this category is further subdivided into the subcategories. We will see the details. As I mentioned, 4.1 is a fruit. 4.1.1 is a fresh fruits. 4.1.1 is a untreated fresh fruits. 4.1.1.2 is a surface treated fresh fruits like a wax coated fruit. 4.1.1.3 is a peeled or cut fresh fruits. Nowadays, many peeled or cut fresh fruits are available in a supermarket, and that is a trend going on. 4.1.2 is a processed fruits. 4.1.2.1 is a frozen fruit. Then it includes a dried fruit. It includes fruit in vinegar, oil or in brine. Then also it includes a can or bottle or pasteurized fruits. It also includes jam, jellies, marmalades, toffee and fruit cheese. Same category in under 4.1, 4.1.2.6, are the fruit products which are based, spread based, like chutney, or excluding the fruit product other category. It also include candied fruits, fruit preparation including pulp, puree, fruit toppings and coconut milk. Fruit based desserts including the fruit flavored water and water based desserts. Fermented fruit products, fruit fillings or pastries and cooked fruits. These all are covered under the fruit category. When it comes to the vegetable as a category, it includes all kind of vegetables including mushrooms, fungi, roots, tubers, pulses, legumes and aloe vera. To give the detailed description of the category, you have to refer to the slide, which include 4.2.1, which is about fresh vegetables, 4.2.1, untreated fresh vegetables, 4.2.2, surface treated vegetables, 4.2.1.3, peeled or cut or shredded vegetables, 4.2.2 are processed vegetables including mushrooms and fungi and roots and tubers. 4.2.2.1 includes frozen vegetables. Nowadays, the frozen vegetable is a big market. But we have to keep the frozen vegetable at appropriate temperature like minus 6 or minus 12 degrees Celsius. 4.2.2.2 includes dried vegetables including mushrooms and fungi. 4.2.2.3 includes vegetable including mushrooms and fungi, pulses, legumes and aloe vera, and seaweeds in vinegar oil or brine or soybean. You must have seen some olives are kept in the brine solution, some olives are kept in the vinegar solution. These are the examples in these categories. Then there is a 4.2.2.4, which is a can or bottle retort pouch vegetables including fungi, roots, tubers, pulses, legumes and aloe vera, but in canned and bottle. Continuing with the same category of fruits and vegetable, it includes vegetable, nuts, seaweeds and purees and spreads. 4.2.2.6 include vegetable, seaweeds and nuts and seed pulp preparations and its preparation. Fermented vegetables, which includes all the seaweeds, all the mushrooms, excluding fermented soybean products of the category, which is given in 6.8.6. Then it also include 4.2.8 cooked or fried vegetables and seaweeds. So this, in short, the fruits and vegetable category, which is category number 4, has a very detailed description of various sub-categories. And all the products, not only in India, all globe, you can put in one of the particular reference. The category number 5 is the confectionery items. Confectionery is very popular. The kids love the confectionery and confectionery market is growing day by day. It includes cocoa and chocolate products, which is category number 5.1. It includes confectionery product that may or may not contain cocoa. It includes chewing gum. It includes decorative and icings like on the cake. And it also includes food products solely with any combination of the food conforming to the subcategory as mentioned above, which is 5.4. We'll see the detail. So 5.1 talk about cocoa products, which include cocoa mixes, cocoa and chocolate products, imitation chocolates, chocolate substitutes, all those will fall under 5.1. 5.2 includes confectionery including hard and soft candy. We love the actually soft candy. We love the hard candy, which is the chocolate, which is actually orange candy, nuggets and other food categories, which is a hard candy, soft candy and nuggets. These all falls under 5.2. 5.3 is chewing gum, which we love the chewing gum, bubble gum. And 5.4 talks about decoration products, which including toppings and sweet sauces. Basically, these are the products which is used for the topping on the various items in the confectionery. The category number 6, which is a very important category, which talks about cereal and cereal products derived from cereal grains, from the roots, from the tubes, pulses, legumes and pith of soft core of palm tree, excluding bakery. So this is a vast category. All the cereals like wheat, rice and oats or soya, all these cereal and cereal products, based, processed or unprocessed. We will see in detail the category number 6. 6.1 talks about whole or broken flakes grain, including rice. 6.2 talk about flours and starches. What we eat in a wheat, we eat actually in form of roti through the flours. So it includes in 6.2 category. 6.3 is the breakfast cereals including rolled oat. Whatever you love every day morning, all the cereal products which you eat in morning as a breakfast, it covers in 6.3. 6.4 is a pasta and noodle category. It's one of the biggest category which is growing and kids love those. It includes fresh pasta, noodle and like products. It includes dried pasta and noodle and like product. It includes pre-cooked pasta, which is pre-gelatinized pasta and noodles and like products. 6.5 includes cereal and starch-based desserts, including rice pudding and tapioca pudding. These are the one which you will see in the five-star hotels, the different type of pudding which we love as a sweet products. Then there are the batters for the basically breading and batters for fish or poultry. Then there is a pre-cooked or processed rice products including the rice cakes. Then there is a 6.8 various soya bean products. Because soya industry is a big industry and it requires a separate kind of classification. The 6.8 talked about soya bean products, which includes soybean based beverages, soybean based beverage film, soybean curd, semi-dehydrated soybean curd and dehydrated soybean curd, fermented soybeans, fermented soybean curd and other soybean protein products. So this is a huge category given in 6.8. We'll come to the bakery products, a category number 7. As you are aware that bakery is also growing in India with 12% growth, and bakery is most of the bakery items are in unorganized. But this will give a good categorization and good push to the business that bakery products also could have so many products which falls under the bakery. Basic 7.1 and 7.2 talks about bread and sweet, salty and savory fine bakery varies. So 7.1 talks about bread and ordinary bakery varies and mixes. 7.1.1 talks about bread and rolls. Then 7.1.2 talks about crackers and then other ordinary bakery products. Other bread type products including bread stuffing and bread crumbs. If you go abroad, you will see some bakery items, bakery shops when thousands of products of bakeries are available. And that formats are also being coming to India, and some of the actually supermarkets are keeping the bakery items in one of the corners of the supermarket, and you will see many of the items are on the shelf. So far in bakery we were only knowing about bread and biscuits, but there are so many products which covers in the bakery products. So 7.1 talk about bread and so and so forth. 7.1.5 talks about steam breads. 7.1.6 talk about mixes of bread and ordinary bakery wares. 7.2 talks about fine bakery items and mixes. It includes cakes, cookies and custard types. It also includes fine bakery products, donuts, sweet rolls, scones and muffins. It also includes mixes of fine bakery wares like cake and pancake. These are also the items nowadays the many housewives are preparing those items at the home, and we are going to the donuts and these kind of formats and the shops are available which these products will be included. Now the category number 8 is a meat and meat product. Though India is so called vegetarian country, but there is a large base population, they love meat and meat product. It includes 8.1 is a fresh meat and 8.2 and 8.3 about processed meat. 8.1 talked about fresh meat and poultry, so it includes chicken and fresh meat. 8.1.1 talk about fresh meat and poultry whole or cut. Then 8.1.2 talk about fresh meat and poultry communicated. 8.2 talked about processed meat and poultry products in whole or pieces or cuts. 8.2.1 talked about non-heat treated processed meat and poultry products in whole pieces or in cuts. 8.2.1 talks about actually salted or cured or non-heated treatment given a processed meat. It also talked about dried non-heated treated processed meat and poultry product in whole pieces or in cut. 8.2.1.3 talked about fermented non-heat treated processed meat and poultry products in whole piece or in cuts. Then 8.2.2 talked about heat treated processed meat and poultry products in whole or in cuts. It also talks about 8.2.3, a frozen processed meat and poultry products in whole or in cuts. Then 8.3 category talks about processed comminuted meat and poultry products. 8.3.1 talked about non-heat treated processed comminuted meat and poultry products. 8.3.2 talks about heat treated processed meat and poultry products. 8.3.3 talks about actually frozen processed and edible casings, including sausages and casings. So these are all about meat and meat product. Though India has not developed so many kinds in the meat and meat product, but this category is also growing. And you will see many players are coming and actually occupying the space in these modern formats or modern food industry. Category number 9 is about fish and fish products, which includes mollusks, crustaceans and echinoderms. Broadly, these categories include 9.1, which is a fresh fish, 9.2 to 9.4 about various processed fish, which includes a category including aquatic vertebrates, which are the fish and aquatic mammals, aquatic invertebrates like jellyfish, as well as the mollusks like snails, crustaceans like shrimps, crab and lobsters, and also echinoderms like sea urchins and sea cucumbers. Fish products may be treated with coatings such as glaze or spice rubs prior to marketing and given to the consumers. In the food category systems, which is indicated with the notation for use as glaze or coating. So in short, the fresh fish and various processed fish are covered into the fish and fish products. The detailed descriptions is given into the slide. I will not go into the detail, but you can actually read into the detail from 9.1 to 9.4 with the examples. So most of the fish items which we eat are covered under these categories. Category number 10 is about egg and egg products, which include fresh in shell egg, which is a whole egg, 10.1, product that may be substitute for fresh eggs, 10.2, and other egg product, which is 10.3 and 10.4. So all the egg products are mentioned in the category called 10.0. Fresh eggs, including a liquid egg, frozen egg, and dried egg. Preserved eggs include alkaline, salted, or canned eggs, and egg-based desserts, which includes the custards. So all the egg items are covered into the category number 10. We'll come to the category number 11, which is for sweeteners, including honey. This includes a category number 11.1, all standardized sugars. Then all non-standardized products, 11.2 to 11.6, and natural sweeteners 11.5, which is a honey. In this slide, you will see that all refined and raw sugars from 11.1.1, which is a white sugar, 11.1.2 is a powdered sugar, 11.1.3 is a soft white sugar, lactose, plantation or white sugar, jaggery and gur. These are covered under 11.1. Then 11.2 talks about brown sugar, 11.3 talks about sugar solutions including syrups, partially inverted, including molasses. Then 11.4 talks about other sugar and syrups like xylose, maple, syrups or sugar toppings. 11.5 talks about honey and 11.6 talks about tabletop sweeteners including those containing high intensity sweeteners. Nowadays, there are lot of, apart from the sugar, the use of non-sucrose sugars have increased, and this categorization has actually helped to increase the base of the consumption of those products. The category number 12 talks about salt, spices, soup, sausages, salads and protein products. It has 12.1 to 12.10. 12.1 talks about salt and salt substitutes, herbs, spices, seasoning, vinegars and mustards. Then certain prepared foods, actually this category is soups and broths, sausages and like products, salad. And also there are the soybean based seasoning and protein product other than from soybean. So these are the covered under category number 12. The detailed description about the category is also given in this slide. You can go into the detail how it is subdivided into the various categories. We'll go to the category number 13, which is foodstuff intended for particular nutritional uses, which includes all the food items intended for particular nutrition. 13.1 talks about infant formula, follow formula, and formula for special medical purposes for the infants. Basically, it is an infant formula. Category number 13.2 talks about complementary food for infants and young children. Category number 13.3 talks about dietetic food intended for special medical purposes. It is a medical food. Category number 13.4 talks about dietetic formula for slimming purposes and weight reduction. Category number 13.5 talks about again a dietetic foods, including supplementary foods for dietary uses, excluding a product of food categorization 13.1 to 13.4 and 13.6. And then 13.6 talks about food supplement. Food supplement business with nutraceutical section 22 regulations are out. It's going to be a huge business. So 13.6 talks about food supplements. Category number 14 talks about beverage excluding dairy products. Already dairy products are covered into the category, earlier category. So they are not included in this beverage category. It includes a beverage excluding those covered under the dairy products. So the first 14.1 talks about non-alcoholic beverages. Start with the water, natural mineral water or table waters or soda waters. 14.1.2 talks about fruit and vegetable juices. Various fruit juices, various vegetable juices, concentrates of the fruit juices, concentrate of vegetable juices. You have seen many products are available on the shelf. Fruit and vegetable nectars. Fruit nectar, vegetable nectar, concentrates of the fruit nectar, concentrate of the vegetable nectars. Then 14.1.4 talks about water-based flavored drinks, including sports, energy, or electrolyte drinks and particulated, actually drinks, carbonated water-based or non-carbonated water-based. It also includes a concentrated liquid or solid for water-based flavored drinks. Category number 14.1.5 talks about coffee, coffee substitutes, tea, herbal infusions and other hot cereals and grain beverages excluding cocoa. So this all about beverages under category 14.1. 14.2 talks about alcoholic beverages. Friends, recently FSSA has actually released a standard for alcoholic beverages, including wines. 14.2 covers the 14.2.1, which is a beer and malt beverages, 14.2.2, cider and perry, grape wines, still grape wine, sparkling wine, semi-sparkling wine, fortified grape wine, grape liquor, and sweet grape wine. It also includes wine other than grape, made and distilled spirited beverages containing actually more than 15% alcohol, and aromatized alcoholic beverages including beer, wine, and actually cool type beverages, low alcoholic refreshers. This category, though, is not popular in India, but this is much popular in Western world. Category number 15 is about ready-to-eat savories. It includes all savory snacks, which we love, the kids love. 15.1 talks about snacks, which are potato, cereal, or flour or starch-based. All those snacks which we love are the starch-based snacks. Then 15.2 talks about processed nuts, including coated nuts and nut mixtures, and which include the dried fruits. And 15.3 talks about snacks, which are the fish-based. So this will cover the non-vegetarian section. Category number 16 talks about prepared foods and dishes, including composite foods. This is the category which most of the Indian what we eat in hotel. Actually, category number 16 cover all those items like pav bhaji, ready-to-eat dishes, thali, curried rice, sandwiches, filling with egg, chicken, vegetarian sandwiches, burger, fish burger, pizza, and all those. All the prepared foods will cover under the category number 16, 16.1 to 16.15. Category number 17 is the room for innovation. This is the category for the food items which are not included in other food categories. And they are like silver, actually the silver gold leaves or cashew. Generally, while eating a pan, we have a silver foil, or on most of the mithais or sweetmeat are covered with the silver foil. All those categories which will cover under the category number 17. And this will keep on adding. Category number 19 is the substances added to the food which are not for direct consumption, but they are for the covering under additives. So this category includes food additives, food enzymes, food flavoring, processing aids, nutrients like vitamins, minerals, amino acids, fatty acid, nucleosides, microbial preparations and ingredient of functional nature or actives. This can be in any combination or in any form, such as premixes, postmixes, preparation, emulsions, compounds and mixes. So this is the substitute added to the food, a category number 99. To make it more clear, 99.1 talked about food additives, 99.2 talked about enzymes, like various enzymes are allowed in the refining of the oils and fats. 99.3 talks about flavoring and their preparation. Lot of flavoring agents are allowed in the various food items, including jam, jellies, or confectionery. Then processing aid. 99.5 talks about nutrients and their preparation. 99.6 talk about microorganisms and microbiological preparations. And 99.7 talk about functional ingredients, which may include omega-3, omega-6, oregano, and many other functional ingredients. So friends, to summarize, there are total 18 categories. Category number 1 to 16 talks about various food articles. Category number 17 talks about the categories which are not covered from 1 to 16. And category 99, which is category number 18, talks about all the food additives which are added to the food, but they are not the food. They are the ingredients or additives or emulsifying agents or preservatives. So in nutshell, there are 18 categories, and all the product what you eat in entire India can be placed in one of the categories. So this module may be in detail. You need to read and you need to study and you need to do homework. Whenever you go to any of the supermarket, pick up the product and try to place in one of the categories. And for more reference, please go on to the FSSAI.gov in portals Food Indian Food Code, which has been uploaded. Thank you.